Welcome to Bio-Rad's Blackboard Training, a series of short, informal tutorials brought to you by industry experts. Today, we'll cover systematic allowable error as it relates to total allowable error. Before we get into systematic allowable error, we need to understand systematic error. Systematic error in the laboratory setting is used to describe errors that are caused from instrument malfunction, tech error, and analytical factors. Examples of systematic error include incorrect reconstitution of QC materials, incorrect or expired QC material, incorrect specimen preparation, lack of proper instrument maintenance, calibration errors, or expired reagents and/or solutions. Now that you understand the concept of systematic error, let's define systematic allowable error. SEA is a goal used to describe the accuracy at which a test system should be performing. SEA is one of two components of TEA, which laboratories use to designate quality specifications for clinical testing. There are several schools of thought on how to establish your SEA. One approach is to target SEA at 25% to 50% of TEA. Another option is to calculate the SEA as described in the book Biological Variation from Principles to Practice by Dr. Cullum Fraser. This involves the following data: published biological variation data, and a desired performance goal. Biological variation data includes both within subject data and between subject data. BV data may be found in many publications, including Dr. Westgaard's site, maintained by Dr. Carmen Ricos. Once you have published BV data, the next step is to choose your lab's desired performance goal, minimum, desired, or optimum. The minimum goal is intended for labs that lack the resources to achieve desired performance. Desirable is the most widely accepted and frequently used goal. Finally, optimum is intended for those tests that the desired goal is easily obtained. Now that we have BV data and a desired performance goal, we can use the appropriate formula provided by Dr. Fraser. There are three separate formulas, one for minimum, desirable, and optimal performance. Now let's practice calculating a desirable bias goal for serum glucose. Here are our CVW and CVG values from Dr. Westgaard's site. Let's begin by copying down the formula, and then substituting in the values. Next, square 5.7 and 6.9. Then add the values within the brackets. Take the square root of the product. Finally, multiply the remaining values. The SEA turns out to be 2.24% of the total allowable error. Now let's do a practice equation on your own. This time we'll use the optimal performance equation for serum calcium. Pause the video when the values appear. This will give you a chance to grab a pen, paper, or calculator. Calculate the SEA, then restart the video. I'll provide the correct answer and how I got it. Here are our values. Remember that our formula is in the corner. Go ahead and pause the video now. The SEA is 0.42%. Here's how I got that figure. First, I substituted the values into the formula. Then I squared the values. I added together the values in the parentheses. Then I calculated the square root for the values in the parentheses. Finally, I multiplied the two remaining values. Now that you've established an SEA, let's talk about practical application. If you experience results that fall outside of your bias goal, here are some possible avenues of investigation. Be on the lookout for calibration drift. Look for method bias. This is bias attributed to unsatisfactory laboratory performance. Reportable range error, or an example of a miscalculated mean. Instability. These are errors related to materials, instrument performance, instrument components, or proper maintenance. We hope you found this tutorial helpful. For all of your QC needs, visit www.qcnet.com.